Students, again with your maths class, we have come towards the end of chapter 1, that is knowing our numbers. In the last class, we revised the concept of Roman numerals, which you have learned in earlier classes. Same concept, I have defined the rules, I have given the rules. Hope you all have written by understanding it. There is no doubt about the rules. So the questions related to this Roman numerals are very simple. I will give some questions here. I will explain some questions. Understand it. Write in your notebook. And I will give some questions as homework. That also you have to write it. Questions are related to the concepts you have learned in earlier classes. Hope this is not a new subject, a new topic for you. So starting with the first question. Before starting the question, I will revise the notification used for Roman numerals. L stands for 50, C 100, D 500 and thousands. And you know 1 to 10, how I, then 2I, 3I, 1, 4. Similarly, 10 you represent by X. Now, question 1 is, write Roman numerals for the following. These questions, actually, they are not given as exercise in your textbook, but for your solving, I have created this question. These questions are enough for you. If you understand this and do practice as homework, this will clear your topic. Okay? Now, write numerals for the following 98. Now, 98, these numbers you have to write in Roman numerals. For this, you know, 98 can be written as 90 plus 8. Now, to represent 90 in Romans, you can write as you know, this is C is 100. If you write X here, this will be 100 minus 9, 10, that will be 90. If you are writing to the right, it is added. If you are writing to the left, that is smaller, to the this should be smaller than this, but if you are writing to the left, it is subtracted. So 100 minus 10 is 90 plus 8, you know. So if you combine it, this is XCVIII. So this is the Roman numeral, you got it. Yes, simple. Now 69, you can break and write as 60 plus 9. If you want to write 60, you know L is 50. So I can write L 10 plus IX. Now LX, if your X is here, means you will be adding. So 50 plus 10 is 60. 60 and 9 here is IX. So you will combine and this will be LXIX. Easy? Yes. Similarly, third one, 140. Break and write, convert into Roman numerals using the rules. Now 140 you can write as 100 plus 40. 100 is represented by C. C plus 40 you can represent as XL. How XL? Again, L is 50. This is 10. 50 minus 10, 40. Combine it. This will be CXL. This is your answer. Yes, now it is 586. Again, split this will be 500 plus 80 plus 6. Now 500 is represented by D, so this will be D. Plus 80, 80 means L, X, X, X. 50, 60, 70, 80. This is 80. 6 is VI. Now combine all these things. This is AD, L, X, X, V, I. This is the Roman numeral for 586. Now 444. This is again split it. 400 plus 40 plus 4. Now if you want to write 400, you know for 500 it is D, so this will be D. If you write CD, so this will be 500 minus 100, it is 400 plus 40. How you are going to represent? XL, 50 minus 10, and 4 is 1V. Right? Now combine all these things. So this will be CD, XL, IV. Yes, easy. So just using the rules, you can write the Roman numerals very easily. This is one type of the question you can get related to Roman numerals. Now second, write the following as Hindu-Arabic numerals. Hindu-Arabic means you have to do opposite to this. In this, question is given in Roman numerals. You have to convert in numbers. Okay? Now, this you can write as XXIV. You know, 10, 20, 30. 30 plus 4. This will be 34. Then XL. I told you XL, this is 10, this is 50. Where it is written in the left, minus it. So this will be 50 minus 10, this is 40. Now LXV, L is, yes, this is L, 50 and this is 10. Now this is smaller, it is written to the right, means you have to add. So 50 plus 10 plus 5. This will be 65. Easy? Yes. Now DCXLI. Yeah. Yes. Now D, as you know, it is 500. So I will write as 500. Plus C is 100, this will get add, plus XL, 10 and this is 50, 10 is written to the left, means it will get subtracted, so 50 minus 10 is 40 and I is 1, so 641, so your answer will be 641. Simple, yes. Now same concept, only you have to compare it. Compare the following using less than sign, greater than sign or equal to. Now XC, first comparing, convert in this Roman, in Hindu Arabic numerals or in numbers. So XC is equal to, this is 100, 10, 10 is to the left means minus 100, minus 10 is 90. So XL, XL is, this is L is 50, 50 minus 10 is 40. That means 90 is greater than 40. So you can write XC is greater than XL. Yes, easy?
Yes.
Now, second one. Again, I will convert in Hindu Arabic numeral or numbers. L, X, 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 I, I, I. This is, L is 50, 60, 70, 80. Then 3. So, 50, 60, 70, 80, 3. This is 83. Then XCV. Yes, now C is 100, X is 10, X is written to the left. So 100 minus 10, 90, 90 plus 5, 95. So this is 83 is less than 95. So you can write that in notification. It is less than XCV. Easy?
Yes.
Now, XL and XS. XL is, L is 50, 10, 50 minus 10, 40. XXX, this will be 30. Which is greater? 40 is greater than 30. That means XL is greater than XXX. Yes? Now, yes, this is another one. DC and CD. Now, DC and CD. DC. D is 500, C is 100, this is greater, this is smaller. Return to the right means you have to add it. So this will be 500 plus 100, this is 600. Second is CD. So CD. C is written to the left means minus. So 500 minus 100 is 400. So which is greater here? DC is 600 is greater than 400. That means DC is greater than CD. Easy? You have done this in the earlier class also. So now I will be giving some exercise and questions related to same as this questions only. Solve it, and any doubt is there, please tell me. Now after this, we will be before going to the chapter number 2, your test will be, I will be conducting one test on Thursday. So the questions will be objective only. Be ready, prepare it. Okay, thank you.